Jeff Dunn, the Commissioner of the Alabama Department of Corrections, and I will read a brief prepared statement, and then we'll have members of the victims' families come up to make a brief statement, then I will come back up and answer questions if there are any. Tonight, by order of the Alabama Supreme Court at 8:38 Central Standard Time, the state of Alabama carried out the execution of Nathaniel Woods by lethal injection at the William C. Holman Correctional Facility in Atmore, Alabama. Woods was executed for the 2004 capital murder of three Birmingham police officers. Mr. Woods was offered the opportunity to make a final statement, and he did not. He was pronounced deceased by a physician at 9:01 p.m. And at this time, I'll invite the family members to come up to make a brief statement, and then I'll come back up for questions.
Yes, my name is Star Sidelaker. I'm Harley Chisholm's sister, and my sister Rhonda, and my sister Brenda, and my niece Amelia. I'm speaking on behalf of my sister Rhonda here. She has written, partial justice has been served today for our families. One cop killer down as we patiently wait for the next one. Nathaniel Woods chose his fate on June 17, 2004. That horrific day could have been prevented if he had any kind of compassion or respect for law enforcement. No petitions could stop this day from him taking his last breath. Our loved ones took their last breath while upholding the law to make this city a safer place. Our families will not have closure until Carrie Spencer's execution day. May God have mercy on their souls. Until then, may our loved ones rest in peace. We will forever honor and keep Harley, Carlos, and Robert's legacy alive. These officers will not be forgotten. Heroes live forever.
They do.
That's it.
Hello.
My brother Harley was a sweet, caring, honest, hardworking, gentle-loving man with a huge heart of gold. I know he is proud of his niece and shines down on her. I choose to keep my emotions and feelings of today privately, not publicly. Our hearts were shattered and lives were turned upside down on that horrific day. This past week, it feels like I'm reliving that day all over again. Total strangers in social media have been disrespectful, distasteful, and I am appalled and infuriated. People will always judge and be negative and say what they want to say, wrong, right, or indifferent. But put yourselves in our shoes. There was no need for these senseless killings and the ones that are still going on every day. There's so much hate and anger in this world today. And I think I could speak for all of us as Americans and our families. We need tougher laws, and there needs to be changes. If there's anything anyone can walk away from here tonight and the events of June 17th, 2004, is these families all deserve respect and dignity. I focus on what we all have been through. I pray for all law enforcement officers and their families, and I hope to God they may never face what we had to face. And I pray for peace. And may God bless the Owens and Bennett families. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Amelia Wasinski. Officer Harley Chisholm was my uncle. I apologize in advance. This probably won't be the most exciting sound bit you receive tonight. But I don't want to focus on the events of today or the events of 16 years ago. Rather, I implore a few other things. I would like to begin by saying thank you so much to the state of Alabama and the Birmingham Police Department for always treating us so graciously and so kindly. Truly becoming a part of this family has been overwhelming in the amount of support we've received, so thank you for that. Next, I just implore us to be better in general as a humanity and to everybody. Some of the things that we've seen over the past few weeks have been short of what I would say is inhumane. Social media is a bizarre phenomenon, and experiencing that over the past few weeks has just been, I think, crude for almost everybody involved. I'm not going to speak on behalf of men that aren't here to speak for themselves. I think that's poor practice, and I think we've seen enough of that the past few weeks. I just want to thank everybody again for being so gracious. I don't intend to get emotional about this. And one of the last things I wanted to say is a motto that we've heard commonly through the last 16 years, and that West is best, and we appreciate the Birmingham Police Department so much. Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Susan Bennett, and I'm the wife of Robert Bennett. This is my daughter. This was his sister, brother-in-law. And I'm not here to make a statement in regards to what has already happened tonight, as there's been way too much publicity that has already been given to someone who doesn't deserve an ounce of recognition. This will never, ever bring closure, and it certainly won't bring Rob, Carlos, or Harley back. I do want to talk about Robert Bennett. He was a son. He was a brother. He was a twin, a husband, and a father. And he was truly a great and a godly man. It has been said that a man is not dead while his name is spoken, that we are only truly gone when we disappear from the memories of those who love us. On behalf of my family, I would like to thank those who continue to keep Rob's memory alive, as well as Carlos and Harley. Thank you.